Vue is a wonderful tool for building rich and highly scalable user interfaces. One of its amazing features is its ability to fetch data from other resources and create beautiful interactive websites. When building applications, we'll want to request data from your own or third-party APIs. There are many ways to extract data in Vue, so today we'll take a look at 5 ways you can fetch data in your application. Before we start, we must determine where to do the data fetching. This question really depends on the application. Like, who is interested in the data? Where do we want to display status updates? And where should the optional error message be displayed? In general, it is usually a common parent who will do the job for us. It will fetch the data, store it in local state, and distribute it to the children. However, if you stick around until the end, we'll take a look at the new Vue 3 Suspense API, which tackles this problem differently. And we'll also create our own composable function to maximize reusability. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to hit that like button. The simplest way to fetch data is using the Fetch API. Fetch API is built into most modern browsers and enables us to make HTTP requests using JavaScript promises. We can call the fetch method, providing a URL, and then convert the result to a JSON object. We can take the result and assign it to a ref so that we can access it in our template. While the fetch method is simple and straightforward, we could instead use a library like Axios. Axios is similar to fetch, but it has some nice features. Most notably, it returns the results as a JSON object, so we don't need to convert it. To use it, we'll need to install it using Yarn or another package manager. Then we can import it into our project and use it the same way we use the fetch function. What's also convenient about using Axios is that it has a much shorter syntax, allowing us to cut down on our code, and it also includes a lot of features that fetch does not have. While promises work, in ES7, it's become possible to resolve promises using async await syntax. The benefit of this is it allows us to remove our callbacks and simply get back our asynchronous resolved data. There are actually 2 ways we can use this syntax in our component. The first is we could use an async callback in our onMounted lifecycle hook and assign our values to refs accordingly. However, in Vue 3, we can also have the option of making our setup function async and instead calling our function at the root of our component. What's great about the second approach is that async components can be used with the suspense component. This means if we wrap the component in suspense, it will display the fallback content until the async operation in our component is resolved. We can combine this with an onErrorCapture lifecycle hook to catch any errors. This way we can display a proper error message. Suspense is a very handy component that enables an easy and elegant way of displaying fallback content until async operations are performed. The last way is we could use composable functions. Let's first take a look at some external libraries before we create our own. A popular example is use Axios hook in Vue use. This function wraps around the Axios API and provides some reactive states such as error, loading, and response out of the box. For GraphQL users, we can use Vue Apollo, which provides functions for querying, mutating, and subscribing. Using these libraries isn't necessary, as we could easily create our own query hook that even provides caching. We'll start by creating a useFetch function that will accept 2 arguments. Then we'll create an async fetch function inside where we'll call Axios and pass in the config object. We'll store these results and data in a ref, and in the catch statement, we'll store the error in another ref. On top of this, we can also add a loading indicator to let us know when the status of the request is finished. Now, all we need to do is call our fetch function and return all these properties from the function so we can access them in our component. I'll also add a config skip check to give us options to skip fetching the data if we'd like to do so manually. Sometimes, you may request data from a resource multiple times. If a user navigates away from a page and then comes back, it would be really nice to already have the information saved from the previous request. So let's expand upon our useFetch function by adding caching. We'll create a new function called useFetchCache. This function will accept 3 arguments. a key, which we'll use for caching, as well as the URL and config. We'll also need to initialize a map to store our cache results. This map will also be reactive so that if we update the key multiple times, it will update every single function that depends on it. We'll call a previous useFetch function before, except we'll want to make sure we enabled the skip option since we'll only want to fetch data if it's not in our cache. I'll also create some simple helper functions for updating and clearing the cache using our key. Now, we'll create a new fetch function that will wrap around the old one. We'll do this so we can update or clear our cache if the request is successful. Next, we'll need to define new response and data refs since we'll just want to use the cache map values. Since the cache map is reactive, anytime the value is updated in the map, these computed properties will be updated to reflect that value. We can use our response to make sure we only call the fetch function if it isn't already in cache. Let's return all these values so we can access them in our components. There are also many other ways to fetch data, but these are the most common. If you made it this far, don't forget to like this video. I also have a growing community over on Discord if you have any questions. Hope to see you in the next one.